O succesiune de dinastii tribale au condus în trecut Marocul, culminând cu Alauiții, sultani arabi care au luat puterea în 1668 și o dețin încă și astăzi. Europenii s-au luptat pentru controlul Marocului, francezii reușind să dețină o poziție dominantă. Marocul și-a câștigat independența în 1956, sultanul declarându-se rege sub numele de Mohamed al V-lea. Astăzi, această țară bogată este puternic implicată în agricultură, turism și minerit. Influențele spaniole, arabe, evreie și franceze, combinate cu fondul berber, dau originalitate culturii marocane, ce influențează și gastronomia locală. Bucătăria Marocului este socotită, pe drept cuvânt, una dintre cele mai bune din lume. Puține sunt locurile unde mâncarea este preparată cu atâta grijă și prezentată atât de artistic, atât de delicat servită și atât de gustoasă. Mâncarea marocană se înscrie în două mari categorii. Prima, destinată oaspeților importanți, fiind opera maestrilor bucătari. Nici o femeie nu este prezentă în bucătărie. Bărbații, când sunt serviți, sunt așezați pe saltele sau perne lângă mesele joase. A doua categorie este cea a mâncărurilor gătite cu multă dragoste de către femei, gospodine, numite dada, la ele acasă. Ele petrec ore alături de vasele de pământ smălțuite sau de cele de bronz. Bucătăriile sunt austere, iar sursa de căldură este cărbunele. Aromele specifice bucătăriei sunt cele de coriandru, chimion, șofran, maghiran și sunt amestecate cu cel de ulei de măsline, mentă și trandafiri. Dacă prânzul începe de obicei cu o serie de salate calde și reci, urmate de o tahina sau tocană, hai să facem o cină împreună cu proprietarul primului restaurant marocan din București. Rareori o gazdă marocană depune eforturi timp de o săptămână întreagă pentru a prepara o masă cât mai deosebită invitațiilor săi.
Credeam că în București am testat aproape toate bucătăriile, toate tipurile de gastronomie, dar iată că surpriza m-a adus într-un loc extraordinar, unde am făcut cunoștință cu bucătăria marocană. Ramzi, I'm happy to take the dinner with you. Because I want to share with people who watch my program what you bring new in Bucharest. And let's start looking to the menu, because every time when you take dinner, this is the first step. And before order, I want to explain me the content of each product you have here.
Okay, so actually, the list is in French, but every single dish is translated in Romanian. So we have worm starters, which are our most famous Moroccan worm starters and Tunisian worm starters as well. I would recommend a pastilla, which is the most famous starter in Morocco. So we have a pastilla with chicken and pastilla with shrimps. You can also go for our famous cold starters. I would recommend the salade de mechoui, which is from my hometown, which is from Tunisia. And I can also recommend some soups as a starter, because in Morocco and Tunisia we're having, I think even here you're having.
So you recommend me three starters and the next step will be
and after will be the second plate.
Ah, okay. Now, what is specific like taste in Moroccan gastronomy? Kind of condiments you mixed?
Ah, but I will name you some condiments in their original name, because there is no translation for them.
Really?
So I can name you Ras El Hanout, which is a combination of almost 32 spices. I can name you Tebel, which is a Tunisian combination of spices, 4 or 5 spices. So this, even when they are sold in France, they are not even translated. They are sold with their original name. So we are bringing and importing many spices from Tunisia, from Morocco, and from France, actually.
Is healthy this food or?
My food is very healthy.
Why?
Because I
it's
believe
it's cooked with oil or not? It's
with a lot of olive oil, first
yes.
of all. Most of our dishes are made with olive oil, because it's very used in the Tunisian and Moroccan food. But on top of that, we are using mainly only fresh products here. I mean, I don't have any frozen product in my kitchen. You can, I mean, I'm fully transparent. All the products are fresh. Mm-hmm. I'm using a lot of lamb, a lot of chicken as well, and mainly the taste comes from the spices, actually, the combination of spices.
I see. And for drinking, usually a starter come with a drink. The second plate come with other drink.
Actually, for drinking, you should believe me, I have a lot of proposals for you. I have a nice Algerian, Moroccan, and Tunisian wine, so I'm importing some wines from these countries. And I would recommend for the starter Gris d'Algérie, which is a nice rosé. And then we would go for a Tunisian red wine, which is Château Bouargues. This is the thing that I would recommend, but I know that people are not necessarily willing to have wines from abroad. I also have wines from the Romanian market, of course.
The cooker is a Romanian foreigner. From where he come?
The cooker, if you ask me, he's not Romanian.
He's not Romanian
anymore.
Uh-huh. Huh? Like soul, like experience, or like what?
Like experience, because the cooker, our family is having some Moroccan restaurants abroad in France. Mm-hmm. So he worked with us also in France. He worked in Tunisia. He worked also in Morocco. So the cooker is Daniel, but we name it Hamadi. So it's a nickname, a Tunisian nickname, and we are making the fun of it, because he's so used to our culture, he's so involved in this for years now. So he's okay, he's a Romanian, but he's a Tunisian Romanian, let's say. Uh-huh. Tunisian Moroccan Romanian cook. Yeah.
And how is to have a business like restaurant?
Actually, I arrived in Romania not for this business. My family, especially my mom, is doing this business for about 40 years now. It's her job. She's an expert in this. She opened many restaurants in Morocco, in Tunisia, and in France. She did well so far. And let's say I had to come here in Romania for different reasons. And then I was missing my mom, actually, to tell you the truth. I was missing my mom, and the idea was to tell her, Mom, the best thing that you know is to manage a restaurant. You are a good cooker, you know the best recipes. This concept doesn't even exist in Romania, and I'm pretty sure, because I know the Romanians, they like to taste new things. I'm pretty sure if we open that kind of business, you will be happy to be close to your beloved son, and this will work, I think. So the idea starts from here, to bring my mom close to me. This was the original.
You know
idea.
That a lot of people are saying about food, to be good, any food, you must put love and passion there. Who is with love and passion here?
So I think when you will taste the food, you will feel a lot of love.
Okay, let's start to taste it.
So Luana, the best thing to start a Moroccan dinner is to open it with a Moroccan tea. Let's order a nice Moroccan tea with mint and with almonds.
Do you serve the tea with sugar?
Actually, here there is a big debate between the fans of diet stuff and between the authentic people in Morocco.
Put here the almonds.
You can put the almond here, but I recommend you to have it in a small sweet way, not too much. You will appreciate it more. It's very small.
Very small. But it already has inside,
yeah,
a little bit.
Little.
So inside we have mint.
We have mint. We have a specific gunpowder green tea, which is actually it's a Chinese tea, but used in all Morocco and all the North Africa, and a lot of mint, which is the secret. The Moroccan tea is known to be light; it's not a strong tea. To be very sweet, as that's why I told you we have a debate here, because I know people don't like very much sweet tea, but it's the way it should be, and very light. And you can have liters and liters and liters after, you can sleep very, very easily. There is no problem with that.
But it's very good, it's tasty.
So now, Luana, let me show the Moroccan way to serve the tea. Because it's a little bit more folkloric. Here you are. And on top of that, you can add some almonds like we have now, or some pines. You call it mougour d'épine, I think. Mm-hmm. And this is the traditional way
Thank
to
you.
Serve it.
Ramzi, I want to describe me again what I choose.
This one is the Croustillon Medina. Actually, it's three rolls filled with goat cheese, with honey, and with hazelnuts. So here you have a balance and a mix between sweet taste and some salt taste. It's in the Moroccan food, there are a lot of combination between sweet and salty, and it's very, very tasty. I'm sure you will appreciate. Of course, the side dish is with a little salad, and I think here I made a good choice for you.
And your plate, what it is?
I know that mainly we are in a Moroccan environment, but actually my origins are Tunisian, and I wanted to have also some Tunisian dishes within the menu, but the cuisine is very close. This is the famous salad mechoui. It's one of the most famous salad in Tunisia. It's a mix of grilled vegetables, let's say, tomato, pepper, and onions, and combined with a lot of Tunisian spices, up to 10 different spices, which makes it taste very specific. Actually, the best way to enjoy this dish is to try it, more than to describe it.
And with fish?
Yeah, with tuna aside. Uh-huh. So it depends. We can serve it with or without, but generally it's served with tuna fish on top of it. Merci.
Thank you for inviting.
Saha, we say in in our language.
Yes. Saha, Norok. Exactly. Kind of surprise, I understand, the next plate.
Yes, now the serious things are coming. Now we are going to talk about the real food. We were joking until now, now we are going to have very tasty food. You will appreciate, I'm sure. This is a couscous royal. We call it royal when we have all the different kinds of meat in it. We have lamb, chicken, another different kind of lamb, and merguez, which here you call carnats, but it's a specific one. It's a homemade carnats, and it's made with lamb and beef and with a lot of spices.
So this is my plate or yours?
This is our plate. We share everything here. In our culture, we share everything. Normally, this is the couscous, so la semoule, we call it. And here you have the vegetables in a specific bouillon. And you have to mix this with this.
Norok again.
Actually, I lied to you. This is only for me. For you, I have a special surprise. It's coming right now.
I see. And what is inside?
So you have vegetables, chicken, of course, because it's a tagine de poulet, so it's a tagine of chicken. A lot of spices. I cannot tell you all of them because there are many. You have some caramelized onions on top. And you have some olives and many, many other vegetables and many spices, trust me. But as I told you for the previous dish, the best way to know this dish is to taste it.
So for each client, you order in this recipient?
Exactly. So actually, tagine is the name of the recipient. Uh-huh. It's taking his name from the recipient, which is also named tagine. And this is cooked. Actually, in this tagine, it goes directly on fire. This.
So it's one portion inside.
Exactly. This is one portion. I know it's quite
so
big.
So I need to eat everything.
Please.
And to share also with you this?
Exactly.
Wow, I'm in paradise. Discover more with the dessert. What kind of surprise?
You still have some space for
yes.
dessert? Yes,
I reserve some.
Okay, so if you have some space, I have for you the best dessert ever. Yes, it's the best dessert ever. It's the pastilla au lait. Trust me with this, I have 100% success. You will absolutely love it. Thank you, Sorin.
So this is
this is the pastilla au lait. Mm-hmm. This is crepe berbère. It's a berbère pancake. Mm-hmm. It's done with honey and hazelnuts. This dessert is terrific. Actually, I'm jealous because I'm almost about to switch the plate, but even this one is very good. We're gonna share it, okay?
Okay.